Hello children, myself Indu Miss, your maths teacher. We are starting our revision. So from mensuration, now I am starting. First question. If the curved surface area of a cylinder is 1760 centimeter square and its base radius is 14 centimeter, then its height is dash. We have to find the height of the cylinder. So two informations are given, one is curved surface area of the cylinder and other is base radius. So how can we find out? So base radius is 14 centimeter, then we can write curved surface area is given 1760 centimeter square. Whenever area volume like that, perimeter and all, then you have to substitute the formula. Then curved surface area is 1760, that means 2 pi r h, that is a formula for finding the curved surface area of a cylinder. So 2 pi r h is 1760 centimeter square. Substitute that values, 2 into 22 upon 7 into r is 14 centimeter is given in the question, and h we have to find out, so we will keep it like that. So h is equal to 1760 centimeter square divided by 2 into 22 into 2 centimeter. So here simplification is given, 1760 when we are dividing by, first we can do by 2, then it is coming 880, then again we can do by 2, then we are getting 440, then 440 when we are doing by 22, we are getting 20. So height of the cylinder is 20 centimeter. Now second question, a cylindrical tank has a capacity of 6160 meter cube and its base diameter, find its base diameter if its depth is 10 meter. Here capacity and depth, capacity means volume, depth means height. We have to find the base diameter. So using this capacity and depth, we can find out the base radius. After that, we can find base diameter. So here height is given 10 meter, capacity, height, depth means height, capacity means volume, that is given 6160 meter cube. Then here also volume is given, so we can write down the formula. What is the formula? Pi r square h. Pi r square h is equal to 6160 meter cube. Then you substitute the value. R is not given, so that will remain same. H is given 10 meter, that we can substitute. Now r square, that we have to find out. R we have to find out. So r square we are keeping alone and take other these that side. So these two are in numerator, so that will go in denominator, that side. And this is in denominator, so that is coming in numerator. So r square is equal to 6160 meter cube into 7 whole divided by 22 into 10. In that 0, this we can simplify. Here I did its calculation, 6160 into 7 divided by, so 0 0 is going. When it is doing by 22, then 616 you can do by 22, 22 into 28, so we are getting 28 into 7 meter. This don't multiply. If you want, you can multiply and then you can find out the square root, then you will get a bigger number, then it will take time to find out separately. Here in mind, if you are factorizing here, you can find in mind. Anyway, you can do. Okay, I always do it like this, because then we can save time. So r square is 28 into 7. So r is square root of 28 into 7 meter square. This 28 we can factorize. 4 sevens are 28. So 4 into 7 into 7 meter square. Now look here. Here 7 is coming 2 times. So square root means 1 time we can take outside. 4 is a perfect square, so its square root we know 2. So 2 into 7 meter. Meter square is given, so its square root is meter. So radius we got 14 meter. So how can we find out diameter? Diameter is 2 is the radius, that is 2 into 14 meter, that is 28 meter. So final answer is 28 meter.